Well, travel in some parts of the area difficult this morning because of some slick spots. And KMBC 9's Micheal Mahoney has been looking into why they're still around well over 24 hours after we got that light snowfall. Micheal?
Kelly, it really wasn't the snow that was the problem today. It was the ice on some troublesome intersections that caused problems for drivers. The hill on 41st Street at Paseo in Kansas City, where this small car couldn't make it all the way up.
We are dealing with spotty ice conditions that have popped up on roads where there might be a low-lying dip in the road and some of the snow is packed in to create a little icy patch.
And it wasn't any better coming down the same hill, as this van demonstrates. Another early trouble spot was at 31st and Roanoke, where police officers had to manage the traffic due to slick streets. A lot of the trucks that were out today in Kansas City, Missouri, were clearing curbside snow. They were not applying salt.
When the temperatures get down below about 15, you're just wasting money tossing the salt out there on the pavement.
Both Kansas City, Missouri and Overland Park, Kansas report they have stocked up to normal levels of snow removal material, like salt. Kansas City, Kansas, however, only has half as much as normal because the city budget is so tight. Kansas City did not apply salt today because of the conditions, not because of the budget.
The fear is that when you have a temperature like this that's just barely enough that the salt will work, you might get refreezing at night that's worse than the, you know, the slick spot you had.
Back live here at one of the big salt domes for the city of Kansas City, Missouri. So there could be some more slick spots tonight, but everybody wants to really know what the long-term forecast for the winter is. And according to NOAA, the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration, in our part of the United States, it is supposed to be a warmer and drier winter than normal. We'll see.